Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another episode of the Crazy Blind Tech Podcast. In this episode, we'll be going through my live reaction to the Apple event. This is my first time seeing it. I haven't seen it before. The September 2023 Apple event.
All right, guys, let's get into this.
In a window, clothes hang from a drying rack and blow in a light wind. A man sits on the floor below and looks out the window. He taps his Apple Watch. Subtitles: Happy birthday, Dad. I hope you're looking forward to the party. Now, a mother leans into a crib and pats her baby. In a kitchen, a man pours a cup of coffee. Steam rises.
This is very birthday themed.
A text message on his iPhone reads, "Have a great birthday." Now, a man kneels on a prayer rug and presses his forehead to the ground.
Happy birthday.
A man kisses his partner and rises from bed. In a car, a girl checks her Apple Watch. A text message reads, "Happy birthday."
What is this weird song? Is this like a kid singing?
A woman stretches toward the ceiling. Now the man who is praying showers. A text message in Arabic appears on his iPhone from Luna, my lovely mother. Subtitles: Happy birthday, love mom. In a backyard, a group of people cheer for the mother. She smiles and embraces them. Now at a restaurant, the dad and party guest tap their glasses together. In a kitchen, the man with the coffee smiles.
Also, why does the person singing sound like they're like
at a beach,
behind me?
She brushes over the girl from the car's feet. She smiles and her mother takes her hand. Three women dance in a kitchen. Now, birthday cakes with burning candles are presented at the parties. The dancing women carry a cake and approach the woman who is stretching. She brings her hands together. Tears well in her eyes. Titles: Tasha Prescott. Apple Watch notified her of a low heart rate, went to the hospital, and received vital pacemaker surgery.
Jeez.
I'm appreciative of just life, another opportunity. My kids experiencing things because I'm still here.
Antonio Femiano, caught in a blizzard as hypothermia set in, used emergency SOS via satellite on iPhone to get rescued.
It's always great to get up in the morning and be here, living one more day with them.
Stephen Watts, got trapped while rappelling, used emergency SOS via satellite on iPhone and was airlifted out.
It's so exciting to live and to be here with people you love.
Omar Hashem passed out from a seizure and crashed his car. Crash detection on iPhone called 911 while he was unconscious.
I'm thankful for my friends and family who supported me. I'm super thankful to my life.
Amani Miles, Apple Watch alerted her of a high heart rate, leading to the discovery and removal of a tumor. She is now cancer-free.
Everybody has always said she's going to be somebody really
insane.
Great when she grows up. I believe that.
Imani's mother holds her.
They always do these like really heavy animations and stuff.
Apple Watch detected an irregular heart rate, leading to surgery for severe heart arrhythmia. Subtitles: To live a life like this, to have friends who gather for you and spend time with you is a beautiful feeling.
We're so glad you're here with us, Jesse.
I know.
We're so glad.
Love you so much.
Titles: Jess Kelly. Apple Watch notified her of a high heart rate. Doctors rushed her into emergency delivery, saving her and her baby's life.
I'm here. Shelby's here. And I'm super thankful for that.
Okay, now can I pull out these two?
Jess wipes her tears. Omar laughs with his family. Imani's mother chases her into the water. Titles: This year they all celebrated a birthday they thought they'd never have. Omar, Steven, Jess, Tasha, and Masahiko blow out their candles.
Seriously though, what is this music? This music is so freaking weird. Like, what even is this?
Yes, raise their glasses. Now on iPhone videos, he floats on a surfboard and plays with a pet bird. Omar cuts a slice.
Sometimes these are so, like, long, like I kind of wish they would just get into the event.
Tasha and a child play drums. Steven holds his baby and plays with his dog. Antonio throws an axe at a target board. Imani dances and lies in the grass. She runs with her family at the beach. Now, she blows out birthday candles. The Apple logo. We soar across the solar panels atop Apple Park. We gradually
Okay, here we go. This is like the typical animation. We're going to go fly onto the stage.
We lower to the path and fly over the grass where Tim Cook stands. He steeples his hands.
Good morning. Welcome to Apple Park.
Good morning.
We're so excited you could join us
Except
today
it isn't morning.
For some big announcements about two essential products, Apple Watch and iPhone. Like we just saw, nothing's more important than helping save lives.
And so, it's no new iPads this year.
All the ways people use Apple Watch and iPhone every day. We're going to talk more about what's coming next to these products. But first, I'd like to provide a couple of updates, starting with...
Hold up, how's the ambience in stereo, but he's in mono? That's a fake ambience.
Even better. We introduced the two most powerful Macs we've ever shipped, the new Mac Studio and Mac Pro. This completed the transition of the Mac to Apple Silicon. We also introduced the world's best 15-inch laptop, the new 15-inch MacBook Air. And the reaction has been fantastic. Tom's Guide said the 15-inch MacBook Air is the best 15-inch laptop you can buy. And Marques Brownlee said the 15-inch MacBook Air is going to instantly rocket to the top of the lineup to become the most popular 15-inch laptop.
Okay, so they haven't done this before where they used, like, people, like YouTubers like Marques Brownlee to like, push their products. That's very interesting.
We also unveiled Apple Vision Pro, an entirely new spatial computing platform where your digital content seamlessly blends with your physical space. Everything looks better on Vision Pro, including your favorite TV shows and movies.
Whoa, there's some background noise. Oh no, they broke that.
And the response to Apple Vision Pro has been absolutely amazing. We're so pleased that people are as excited about Apple Vision Pro as we are. Apple Vision Pro has also captured the imagination of our remarkable developer community. We're extremely excited about what they're already showing us in our developer labs around the world. They're creating truly amazing experiences that wouldn't be possible on any other platform. Our Apple team is also making great progress with Vision Pro, and we're on track to ship early next year. We look forward to sharing Apple Vision Pro and its breakthrough spatial experiences with all of you. Now let's get to the big news of the day about Apple Watch and iPhone.
Finally.
Their innovative features and industry-leading technologies help improve our lives in so many meaningful and delightful ways. Apple Watch helps us stay healthy, active, and connected. And iPhone impacts just about everything we do. They're with us all the time. And if you left either one at home, I bet you'd go back and get it. So we're excited to talk about how we're
taking Apple Watch and iPhone. The things I'm doing are more important than my devices.
Let's get started with Apple Watch. Here's Jeff to tell you more.
We fly forward, then rise above Apple Park. The Santa Cruz Mountains stretch across the horizon. We tilt up to a clear blue sky, then dip back down, emerging above the San Francisco Bay, downtown San Francisco ahead. The Salesforce and Transamerica buildings pierce the sky, and Pier 7 extends over the water. We fly toward it, lowering to the wooden pier. Titles, Jeff Williams, Chief Operating Officer.
Why are we on a pier?
Apple Watch helps millions of people live a better day. It monitors your health, motivates you to be active, connects you to the people and information you care about, and can even contact help if needed. And today, I'm excited to introduce the next generation of Apple Watch.
A video plays. Light glides across a pink Apple Watch case. The display illuminates. A band of pink light reflects on its edges. A midnight Apple Watch turns and blue light follows its path. An Apple Watch user taps their thumb and index finger together twice. A call on their Apple Watch ends. Fade to black.
Apple Watch is the world's most popular watch, and Series 9 takes it to the
next
level.
That's a new feature, ending a call with like a
thing like that.
Amazing
new features that you'll use every single day. Here's Deidre to tell you all about it.
Jeff looks at his Apple Watch, which displays video feed of a lab. We zoom into it. Titles Deidre Kalbeck, Director, Apple Watch Product Marketing.
Apple Silicon powers the incredible capabilities built into every Apple Watch. Designing our own chips and tightly integrating them with watchOS unlocks innovative features like advanced workout metrics, sleep stages, and car crash detection. Apple Watch Series 9 has been redesigned on the inside with the all-new S9 SIP, giving it a big boost in performance and capabilities.
What's a SIP?
It's our most powerful watch chip yet. The S9 CPU has 5.6 billion transistors, 60% more than Series 8, and its GPU is 30% faster. The new S9 chip makes the animations and effects in watchOS 10 look super smooth. S9 also has a new 4-core neural engine that can process machine learning tasks up to twice as fast. This powerful custom silicon is what allows us to maintain all-day 18-hour battery life while adding new features and system-wide improvements to Series 9. Because it's always on you, Apple Watch is often the easiest and quickest way to use Siri. To check the score, close the garage, or send a message, just raise your wrist and ask.
If I had a new Apple simple. Watch to make that easy, mine's
Thanks
laggy.
Thanks to the powerful new neural engine, Siri requests are now processed on device, making them faster and more secure.
This I thought they already were.
The
Maybe not.
Most common requests, like Siri, start an outdoor walk workout, no longer have to go to the cloud, so they can't be slowed down by a poor Wi-Fi or cellular connection. And because the neural engine can run a more advanced transformer model, dictation on Series 9 is up to 25% more accurate than on Series 8.
Thank you, because dictation on
Secure
the Apple Watch
device
sucks.
Processing also enables a brand new feature, the ability to access your health data with Siri. So now you can ask, how much did I sleep last night? What's
Why
my
do
average
you need
walking
a new
heart rate?
What?
Or how does my move ring look today? And you can log health data, like your weight or period, or that you've taken your medications, with just your voice. Siri health queries will be available later this year in English and Mandarin, with more languages to follow. Apple Watch is perfect for interacting with nearby objects like smart locks, gym equipment, or payment terminals. At home or out in the world, your watch connects to all kinds of devices, making so many of the things you do easier. And with watchOS 10, you can use NameDrop to instantly share your contact information with another person's Apple Watch. This year, Apple Silicon enhances another one of our users' favorite nearby or faraway features, the ability to ping your iPhone. Series 9 has a new second-generation ultra-wideband chip that enables precision finding for iPhones with the same chip. You'll see both the distance and direction to your iPhone.
Oh, like the AirTags. That is the coolest thing ever.
And audible
that is
feedback
actually
guide
really
you
nice.
To its location, even if it's in a different room. Ultra Wideband also brings new integration between Apple Watch and HomePod. When you get close to your HomePod, media suggestions will automatically appear at the top of the smart stack, so you can instantly fire up a playlist or podcast. Or if audio is already playing, your watch will launch Now Playing to let you control it. Series 9 features a big edge-to-edge, always-on Retina display that's even easier to read outdoors because it now goes up to 2,000 nits, double the brightness of Series 8.
I was going to say, isn't that like double?
The display is also better in very dark situations, like a movie theater or early morning wake-up, because it now goes down to just one nit. These features will be useful every time you put on your watch. But that's not all. The powerful SIP also enables an incredible new capability.
What is a SIP?
Back to Jeff to tell you about it.
What is SIP? That was a chip. Why is it SIP?
Innovations on Apple Watch, like the digital crown and Taptic Engine, along with tap, swipe, and double click, make it simple and intuitive to use. Apple Watch is also controlled by gestures, like wrist raise, which brightens the display to let you check the time, read notifications, or see who's calling with a glance. You can even cover the display to silence alerts. Today, we're adding something really cool. Series 9 enables an incredible new gesture that uses just your watch hand. It's especially convenient for those common situations when your other hand is occupied, like walking the dog or holding a cup of coffee. We think you'll use this all the time. Introducing Double Tap. Just tap your index finger and thumb together twice. It's that easy. You can use Double Tap to answer a call. Let me show you.
Jeff raises his Apple Watch and taps his index finger and thumb together twice.
Hi, Deidre.
Hey, Jeff.
This same gesture also works to end a call. See you later.
Okay, bye.
He double taps again, and the call ends.
Double Tap controls the primary button in an app, so you can use it to stop a timer, play and pause music, or snooze an alarm.
Kind of like VoiceOver's Magic Tap functionality.
Double Tap will also launch the smart stack from your watch face. Double tap again to scroll through the widgets, just like turning the digital crown. This new gesture is enabled by the powerful neural engine in Series 9, which processes data from the accelerometer, gyroscope, and optical heart sensor in a completely new way. It uses a machine learning algorithm to detect the unique signature of tiny movements and changes in blood flow when your hand and fingers perform a double tap. Check out Double Tap in action.
A video plays. An Apple Watch user sleeps in a bed. An alarm on their Apple Watch set for 2:15 p.m. starts. The user taps their thumb and index finger together twice. The alarm snoozes. Now, Apple Watch users answer incoming calls with Double Tap. A rock climber hangs from a hold with one hand.
Hello?
A user brushes their teeth.
Hello?
A beekeeper holds a beehive panel. He swats away bees. Now a user baking cookies double taps to start a 4-minute timer on their Apple Watch. Two people hold hands at a carnival. One answers a call with his free hand with double tap.
Hello?
Sleeping children lean against their parents. A mother resumes an episode of Foundation using double tap on her Apple Watch. A family poses for an iPhone photo. An Apple Watch user double taps her fingers to capture the image in camera. Now in a library, a student talks on a call on her Apple Watch. She rolls her eyes at a librarian, then double taps her fingers. The call ends. Apple Watch users double tap their fingers.
Obnoxious person. Titles, magic, that was amusing. Fingertips.
The napping Apple Watch user snoozes her alarm again. The Apple Watch Series 9 logo.
Get up, dang it. It is time to get out of bed.
Watch faster, easier, and more convenient. It will be available next month, and we can't wait for you to start using it. Because once you do, it will become one of those magical experiences you rely on every day. Series 9 will be available in a gorgeous new pink aluminum case, plus starlight, silver, midnight, and product red, and stainless steel cases in gold, silver, and graphite.
Is that seriously all that's new? That's not very exciting.
We've also been innovating in another important direction.
Okay, here we go.
Towards our industry-leading environmental goals. We recently had the chance to share our progress with a special guest.
A video plays. At Apple Park, a woman carrying an iPad walks briskly down an interior corridor. She picks up her pace and mumbles under her breath. Inside a conference room, Tim Cook sits at a long table.
Oh, welcome to Apple. Welcome to Apple. Hi, I'm Tim.
She should be here any minute.
How is the weather coming in? Hi, I'm Tim.
Lisa Jackson breathes deeply.
Yeah, I'm gonna do the office is already carbon neutral, right?
Yeah, all yours.
The woman with the iPad turns to a shelf and spots a dead plant. She collects its fallen leaves, tucks them into her pocket, then hides the plant behind her back. The light in the conference room dims. Members of the team look up. Tim turns to the window. Outside, the branches of the orchard tree sway and part from a wind. A cluster of leaves bends in the air. The rainbow stage stands bright below a cloudy sky. Back in the conference room, the table rumbles. Water glasses tremble.
What?
A ladybug lands on a glass.
I hope we didn't keep you waiting.
Tim and team turn. Octavia Spencer sits at the table.
Mother Nature, welcome to Apple. How is the weather getting in?
Mother Nature tilts her head and grins. The room darkens. Outside, clouds block the sun.
The weather was however I wanted it to be. Let's cut to the chase. In 2020, you promised to bring Apple's entire carbon footprint to zero by 2030. Henry David Thoreau over here.
Tim blinks.
Said we have a profound opportunity to build a more sustainable future for the planet we share.
I think our 10 o'clock said the same thing.
They all do. All right. This is my third corporate responsibility gig today, so who wants to disappoint me first?
Well, we've got some updates we're excited to share with you.
Materials, status.
Is there a materials person here?
Yes. We are in the process of eliminating all plastic from our packaging by the end...
Let me guess. 50 years from now, when someone else is left holding the bag?
By the end of next year, actually.
And we're also currently using 100% recycled aluminum in the enclosures of all our MacBooks, Apple TVs, Apple Watch.
What about iPod Shuffle?
Members of the team glance at each other.
I don't want to do that.
It's a joke. Don't you people make Ted Lasso?
Look, that's a different group.
We're also phasing out leather in our iPhone cases.
What about Brando over there? They phasing you out too?
Oh.
The team member looks down at his leather jacket.
What's next?
Electricity.
Electricity status.
We're operating on 100% clean electricity.
What runs on 100% clean electricity?
Every Apple office, store, and data center runs on clean electricity, thanks to you and your powerful wind and sun. Mm.
And Apple offices are already carbon neutral.
Yeah. This building is carbon neutral?
Oh, yeah, we do it with a mix of clean energy and eliminating greenhouse emissions. It's kind of like if you were to...
You're seriously explaining carbon neutrality to Mother Nature?
Right, no, I'm sorry.
You want to tell me how photosynthesis works too? Don't.
Also, over 300
suppliers have committed to
using
100%
clean, renewable electricity.
What's next?
Transportation.
I'm
proud to report that we're shipping more products by ocean rather than air, which reduces transportation emissions by 95%.
95%?
Mother Nature stares unaffectedly.
Not too bad.
I'm also happy to report that we're investing in projects around the world that protect the Earth's soil, plants, and trees.
Everyone says they're planting trees.
We've planted forests.
Oh, hello.
Where?
Paraguay, Brazil.
What, are you trying to save the tropical savanna?
Mother Nature rises. She walks toward Lisa.
Yes. And we've also restored mangroves in Colombia.
What else?
Grasslands in Kenya.
Why?
Our aim is to permanently remove carbon from the atmosphere.
Members of the team nod and closely watch Mother Nature.
What about your water usage?
We've reduced it.
By how much?
63 billion gallons.
63 million?
Billion.
Lisa nods, holding her hands calmly on the table. Mother Nature suppresses a smile. She turns and walks slowly to the window, her hands joined behind her back. The team watches anxiously. Outside, the sun breaks through the clouds. Tim stands.
As you can see, we've innovated and retooled almost every part of our process to reduce our impact on the planet. By 2030, all Apple devices will have a net zero climate impact.
All of them?
All of them.
They better.
They will.
Mother Nature stares at Tim. He looks back, a serious expression on his face. Mother Nature squints one eye slightly.
Okay, good. See you next year.
Don't disappoint your mother.
Mother Nature and her assistant exit. Tim rubs his head. Members of the team smile in relief. The woman continues to hold the dead plant behind her back. Now it grows. Five green petals transform into the Black Apple logo with a green petal.
As you can see, we've been working on
again,
some really
that was
big environmental
far,
initiatives.
Far too overkill and unnecessary.
To share more, here's Lisa.
We rise above Jeff and lower to a dry, sun-baked field. Huge solar panels stretch across the grass and rows. Titles Lisa Jackson, VP Environment Policy and Social Initiatives.
At Apple, our mission is to make products customers love and protect the planet at the same time. 3 years ago, we made our corporate operations around the world carbon neutral. It was the first step towards our most ambitious environmental commitment to date, Apple 2030, our plan to be carbon neutral across our entire business by the year 2030. The next step is getting the carbon footprint of all of our products down to net zero. For Apple Watch Series 9, we challenged ourselves to significantly reduce greenhouse gas emissions from their three biggest sources: materials, electricity, and transportation.
Okay. But
maximizing recycled and renewable materials in our products
is
key to Apple 2030 because they have a lower carbon impact than virgin materials. So we use 100% recycled aluminum in our watch cases, plus recycled gold, tin, copper, tungsten, and more inside of Series 9. And for the first time, there is 100% recycled cobalt in the battery. We also redesigned one of our most popular watch bands, the Sport Loop, to use more recycled material. It is now made with 82% recycled yarn, while maintaining the softness and comfort you love.
82%.
Electricity is the biggest
source of carbon
emissions.
You'd think that would be the easiest thing to make recyclable.
Since 2015, we've been investing in renewable energy, like this solar installation in Central California, while helping our suppliers do the same. And we're excited to announce that starting this year, all Apple Watch manufacturing is powered by 100% clean electricity. Charging is
that's
another
good,
source
at least.
Of emissions.
That's very, very
while
good.
While it's a small amount per person across millions of watch wearers, it adds up. So we decided to do something about it. For Series 9, Apple will match 100% of your expected electricity use by investing in renewable energy projects around the world. Finally, we looked at
what are you going to collect how much I charge my Apple Watch? Because I don't really want that.
To cut emissions from transportation, we started by redesigning Series 9 packaging to be 100% fiber-based and more compact. It has a new, smaller shape that lets us ship up to 25% more watches per trip. And more of those trips will be made with low-carbon shipping modes, like ocean freight, which emits just 1/20th of shipping by air.
Our efforts to reduce emissions from materials, electricity, and transportation resulted in a whopping 78% decrease in the carbon footprint. The small amount
that
of
isn't
emissions
bad.
That remain
that isn't bad.
Offset by high-quality credits from projects like forests and wetlands that actively
no, that does not offset them. The only thing that will offset them is stopping them.
This last step brings the net carbon footprint of Apple Watch Series 9 down to zero, making it our first ever carbon neutral product.
No, it doesn't.
Any
truly,
combination
it just
of aluminum
is a compensation
series 9
method.
And new Sport Loop is carbon neutral and has been certified by an independent third party. To help you recognize it, you'll see this new logo on the box.
Titles carbon neutral.
We are so excited about this achievement, and it's how we plan to get all Apple products to carbon neutral by innovating across design, engineering, and operations to steeply reduce emissions before applying high-quality carbon credits. While Apple 2030 is the destination, the journey is important too. So we looked for additional opportunities to make change. Leather is a popular material for accessories, but it has a significant carbon footprint, especially at Apple scale. To reduce our impact, we will no longer use leather in any new Apple product, including watch bands. And that starts today. Now, back to Jeff to tell you more.
We've developed a beautiful, luxurious, and durable new textile that we're calling Fine Woven. It's made of 68% post-consumer recycled
content.
We're
going to talk about
which has a
significantly lot of like
lower carbon footprint
the bands
than
and stuff now, I think.
Fine Woven gives the new magnetic link a subtle luster and suede-like feel. And it looks great on the modern buckle, too. Both bands will be available in new colors and offer a sophisticated look for any special occasion. We also explored more environmentally friendly materials with our partners. This year, we collaborated with Hermes on four new styles that draw on their long history in textiles. There are two elegant woven bands, our first ever knitted band, and another in sporty molded rubber, and all come in a range of rich colors. Hermes Radial, a modern take on their classic watch face, complements these innovative new styles. We also
I don't care about the watch bands. I care about the features. Get on with it, Mr. Jeff.
Reducing the use of virgin material. The new Nike Sport Band includes colorful flakes of recycled material. They create a randomized pattern that makes each band unique. For the Nike Sport Loop, we repurposed yarn from previous seasons to make the same soft material with a fun new space dye look. Whoa.
Fun. You hear that phase? He phased.
And there's a new
that's
Nike watch
kinda
face
interesting. I do not care about your watch faces. Can you shut up about your freaking watch
that's the new
bands?
Apple Watch Series 9. It features
that's
a
not very exciting.
Control your watch with double tap, faster on-device Siri that lets you securely access health data.
I really
precision
like Apple's getting
iPhone,
less and less exciting.
And
I think it's because there's not much for them
all
to really do at this point.
S9C,
so it's kind of hard to come up with exciting stuff.
In Apple Watch. And it's Apple's first ever carbon neutral product. Now, let's talk about Apple Watch Ultra.
We turn to the right and up into the clouds. We emerge before the Golden Gate Bridge, then along a cloudy shoreline. We fly inland through fog and lower onto a seaside dirt path. Jeff appears hiking in an orange jacket.
Ultra is the most advanced Apple Watch, and it's perfect for anyone who wants the biggest display and longest battery life with a stunning design. Over the last year, Ultra has helped people accomplish extraordinary feats, like summiting the tallest mountains, completing demanding endurance races, and diving the world's oceans. Ultra is a precision tool designed to go farther, higher, and deeper than any Apple Watch has before. And we've made our most rugged and capable Apple Watch even better. Today,
we're
introducing
let's find
Apple
out how.
Watch Ultra 2.
Obviously, it's going to have like the faster chip and stuff, but like, is there anything else interesting?
And here's Daniela to tell you all about it.
Titles: Daniela Deschamps, Apple Watch Product Design Engineer.
Ultra 2 gets the powerful new S9 SIP. That means you can
why
use
is it
the
a
new
sip?
Double tap gesture
I,
anytime.
I still don't understand
phone.
Why is it a SIP?
Set a waypoint using just your voice with the new on-device Siri, even when you have no connectivity. And precision finding with the second generation ultra-wideband chip helps you easily find your iPhone.
Okay, these are all stuff that are in the new other one, though. Like,
Ultra 2 also has a new advanced display architecture that pushes the brightness to a massive 3,000 nits.
Oh, it's double. It's another display Apple has times ever the created, brightness. That's
and makes Ultra 2 more readable in the harshest sunlight.
That's crazy.
To take advantage of this incredible display, we created an exclusive new watch face called Modular Ultra. It's the first to use the outermost edge of the display to show real-time data like altitude, depth, or the passing seconds. Modular Ultra can be customized to provide the most information at a glance of any digital watch face we have ever made. And now Night Mode uses the ambient light sensor to activate automatically in the dark. Day or
night, that's nice, Ultra but has couldn't you so much done to that offer. Before?
And for runners, it's the perfect choice. With advanced metrics, a big
that is ridiculous
display,
for runners.
A
you don't need a
button, and precision
what?
Dual frequency GPS. And this year, watchOS 10 takes cycling to the next level, allowing you to connect Bluetooth accessories to measure cadence, speed, and power. Apple Watch also helps you get the most out of your training with power zones. And if you start a cycling workout on your watch, it automatically
Sorry.
Shows up as a live activity on your iPhone. Ultra 2 is designed for extremes and has been tested across the largest range of altitudes for any Apple product, from the lowest valleys to the highest peaks. Ultra is also great for your underwater adventures. The Depth app now saves a log each
Now that
session.
Really makes sense,
you
because
right
if you're going
Ultra
diving, the regular
Apple
watch,
iPhone.
You can't go as deep.
From alpine peaks to deep water,
also the light would
to
help
the open road,
a lot.
We can't wait to see where you take Ultra 2. Now back to Jeff.
We fly through a cluster of boulders toward a tall grassy hill. Jeff climbs to its top. White caps form in the waves below.
Even with all these new capabilities, Ultra 2
Again, it's
still
a fake
gets
ambience.
The same
it's
great
stereo.
Battery life. Up to 36 hours of typical use on a single charge and up to 72 hours in low power mode. With Ultra 2, we are also continuing our commitment to the environment. In just 1 year, we significantly increased the amount of recycled content in the case, going from all virgin titanium to 95% recycled. This dramatic improvement in material, along with our work in clean
Why
electricity 95%? And transportation, allowed us to
like,
meet
what is restricting you from going 100% recycled
targets.
Titanium? I don't understand.
Making any Ultra 2 paired with an Alpine Loop or Trail Loop carbon neutral. And this year, the Trail Loop and Alpine Loop and the Ocean Band come in a range of beautiful new colors. And that's the
Yay,
new
Apple colors,
Watch Ultra
new
2.
Fancy colors.
It comes with all the features
so exciting.
Users love about Ultra, plus the powerful S9 SIP, Apple's brightest display ever.
Again, I'm going to ask again, why is it a SIP?
On-device
what
Siri
is a, what is
and a
SIP?
Brand new gesture for easy control of your watch. These innovations and the advancements in watchOS 10 make our most rugged and capable watch even better. Ultra 2 joins Series 9 in the lineup, along with the popular second-generation Apple Watch SE. And we're excited to announce that SE is also carbon neutral when paired with a Sport Loop, which means this fall, customers can buy a carbon neutral model of any new Apple Watch. The Apple Watch SE starts at just $249.
Great, now work on
the
making
Series
all
9
your bands
starts at
carbon
$399,
neutral.
And Apple Watch Ultra 2 is $799. You can order the new Apple Watch models starting today, and they will be available on September 22nd. Now back to Tim.
We fly past Jeff and race downhill.
All right, now we're going to get to talk about the iPhone.
Into the water.
It's probably just going to be some like speed improvements and stuff, but we'll find out.
Now the bubbles freeze. We pull back, revealing the sculpture Mirage by Katie Patterson and Zeller and Moy, weaving glass columns at Apple Park.
I love the new Apple Watch Series 9 and Apple Watch Ultra 2. With incredible new capabilities, they're the most technically advanced watches we've ever created.
Something weird's going on with the audio here. I don't really know what.
Our first carbon neutral product 7 years ahead of our company-wide 2030 goal. Now let's talk about iPhone. Since the very first iPhone, we focused on giving our users a device that's incredibly powerful, remarkably easy to use, and beautifully designed. Every year, we've built on this foundation to create experiences that make a real difference in our users' daily lives. Today, we're pushing what users love about iPhone even further. And I'd like to show it to you now.
A video plays. Light beams from behind a curve in a rounded pink corridor. Shadows skate along contours and light bends to follow their shapes. Light passes over pink columns in the corridor and a bright transparent column appears. A strong light flashes, then emanates from the transparent column. The corridor pulls back, revealing it to be the interior of the camera lenses of a pink iPhone. The iPhone hovers horizontally in a white space. iPhone devices in yellow, green, blue, and black fan out from below it. A pink iPhone emerges. AirPods Pro connection, directions, music by TK Maidza, and an incoming call appear in the dynamic island. Fade to black.
iPhone 15 is absolutely incredible.
Nothing new to showcase in terms of external stuff, apparently.
We fly up, then emerge above downtown San Francisco. We cross over
this
the Bay
weird
Bridge,
freaking music.
Warehouse, then rush through a multi-pane glass window. Inside, a large screen displays iPhone 15 devices. Titles: Kyan Drance, VP, iPhone Product Marketing.
iPhone 15 has an all-new design that's simply gorgeous. Starting from the front, it has the Dynamic Island, which has been a hit with our pro users. The Dynamic Island fluidly expands and adapts to your alerts and live activities.
This is one of the things about the newer phones that I really do not care about.
It feels magical. Now, even more users can easily control their music or see the next direction in Maps. Our amazing community of developers have made the Dynamic Island even more useful by expanding what it can do. Now, you can track a pizza delivery and follow the big game at the same time. When you're catching a flight, you can see which gate you're leaving from and how long until boarding time. It's more helpful than ever. And the Dynamic
Island
looks fantastic.
That's actually kind of useful.
On the Super Retina XDR display, which uses OLED technology. It provides an exceptional viewing experience with thinner borders, rich color, and support for Dolby Vision. And now it's even brighter. Peak HDR brightness reaches 1600 nits, so HDR photos and videos will look better than ever. When it's sunny, peak brightness can now go up to 2000 nits, twice as bright as iPhone 14. It comes in two sizes, 6.1 inches for iPhone 15 and 6.7 inches for iPhone 15 Plus. The larger display
no,
of
we're
iPhone
back to the
15 Plus gives
model
you more
thing
space
again.
For text
Why?
When you're reading the latest article, post, or message. And the bigger display is perfect when you choose larger texts. Both sizes
Why can't we just choose one model and stick with it, Apple?
Due
Come
to
on.
A new contoured edge on the aerospace-grade aluminum enclosure. For the first time ever in a smartphone, iPhone 15 has color embedded throughout a single piece of durable color-infused glass. We use metallic ions to build color into the foundation of the material itself, precisely controlling the saturation to create five stunning colors: pink, yellow, green, blue, and black. To provide the durability our users depend on, we optimized our custom dual ion exchange process for this new material and polished it with nanocrystalline particles. Then it's etched to create a textured matte finish that feels incredible. iPhone 15 has ceramic shield.
That's why their glass feels on the back. It feels like metal, but it's actually glass.
And water and dust resistance, so it's built to last. An iPhone holds its value longer than any other smartphone. This is good for our users and good for the environment, since it helps conserve finite natural resources. Another key part of reaching our goal of carbon neutral products by 2030 is maximizing our use of recycled content, as you heard from Lisa earlier. The enclosure uses 75% recycled aluminum. For the first time, we're using 100% recycled cobalt in the battery and 100% recycled copper foil in the main logic board and MagSafe charger. iPhone 15 has an entirely new advanced camera system. It is designed
More
to help our
things.
Users take fantastic photos of everyday moments in their lives. We're always looking for ways to make it easier for everyone to take gorgeous photos. So we're bringing an amazing 48 megapixel main camera to iPhone 15.
Jeez, that's actually
a
lot.
It's built for shooting sharp photos and videos every day with a quad pixel sensor and 100% focus pixels for fast autofocus. This 48 megapixel camera opens up some exciting capabilities. Say you're outside on a bright sunny day. You can maximize resolution with a 48 megapixel photo like this majestic landscape, which captures the fine details of the mountains, the rolling hills, and even the individual shingles on the houses. Of course, most of the time, it's best to balance detail and light capture. So we use computational photography to take the main camera to the next level. The sensor groups every 4 pixels together into a larger 2-micron pixel for fantastic light capture. Then Photonic Engine takes the image that's been optimized for light capture and combines it
with
super high resolution.
Photonic Engine, it sounds like something in the back of a spaceship that like is going to make me go flying.
The result is a 24 megapixel photo with incredible image quality and double the resolution. It perfectly balances light and detail and has a practical file size that's great for storing and sharing.
And they don't say what the file size actually is.
We can do more than increase the resolution. Using the middle 12 megapixels of the sensor, we enabled a new 2x telephoto option for capturing photos and 4K video with optical quality. It's like having a third camera. It helps you feel closer to the scene. And because it's enabled by the main camera, it has the same f1.6
There's only one camera or there's
two? Sensor shift optical image stabilization, which helps you take fantastic photos even in low light. You can zoom out to capture the whole scene or zoom in for the perfect close-up, all with optical quality. When you're shooting videos, the 2x telephoto also has continuous zoom. So you can frame the scene, like here, in 4K cinematic mode. It helps you feel closer to your subject, so it's perfect for portraits, which are getting even better. To tell you more, here's Maryam.
We pull back, then drift left across the warehouse. Titles, Maryam Azimi.
Obviously, I don't have a lot to say because it's a camera thing, so we're just going to have to sit through this bit.
The next generation of portraits on iPhone. Now, it's even easier to get stunning portraits of your friends and family. Portraits will get richer color and great low light performance. Like this one. It's full of vivid color and detail, and it uses a rich depth map to create a beautiful bokeh effect. In this portrait of a very good dog asking for a treat, iPhone caught the perfect moment with zero shutter lag. A split second later, and it just wouldn't be the same. And it's easier to take your portrait because now you don't have to remember to switch to portrait mode. Using machine learning, we can detect when there's a person in the frame and capture rich depth information automatically. So you can turn it into a stunning portrait right away or later on in the Photos app. It even works with dogs and cats, so you can have more portraits in your pet's album in iOS 17 automatically. And with a rich depth map, we're introducing focus and depth control for a whole new level of creative control. Take this super high resolution portrait. Now, you can switch the focus from one subject to another after the photo's been taken. It gives you so many more options with your photos and less to think about in the moment. When it's dark, night mode is getting better too. Like in this photo, which was taken outside. It has sharp details and vibrant colors, so it beautifully captures the texture of his skin, individual strands of hair, and even the shadows of leaves in his shirt. When lighting is bright or uneven, the latest Smart HDR captures both the sky and your subject with vivid colors and even more true-to-life rendering of skin tones. Look at this colorful selfie shot on the TrueDepth front camera. It uses our new Smart HDR to beautifully capture the deep shades of purple in her shirt and the bright red of the chair behind her. When you're looking at HDR photos in the Photos app, they'll have brighter highlights with richer midtones, so you can really see the rich shades of her dress and how the light hits her cheek just the way it was in real life. By combining advanced computational photography with the 48 megapixel main camera, ultra wide camera, and shoot
by combining
front
blah 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 with blah blah blah. Dude, makes it by doing this or that or the other thing. That's how GPT always is. I feel like this is scripted by GPT.
And it's all powered by Apple Silicon. Back to Kayan.
We turn right, passing a red steel truss. The screen behind Kayan reads performance.
To deliver all of these advanced features, iPhone 15 has an incredible chip, A16 Bionic. It was introduced on iPhone 14 Pro, and it's proven how powerful, fast, and efficient it is. The custom image signal processor enables
the
advanced
chip.
Camera system.
Wow.
So you can capture fantastic
They didn't even bother to upgrade the chip.
Photos and videos.
This is not very exciting, guys. This is probably the least exciting Apple event I've seen yet.
From computational photography to live voicemail transcriptions on device in order to protect your privacy. The 5-core GPU has 50% more memory bandwidth than A15 Bionic, so it's even better for graphics-intensive games. And the 6-core CPU has 2 high-performance cores, which are faster and use 20% less power than A15 Bionic. The 4 high-efficiency cores can handle most daily tasks, so even with all of the new features, iPhone 15 still has all-day battery life. An iPhone 15 Plus has a bigger battery that lasts even longer for those days when you forget to charge or just want to spend more time gaming, browsing the web, or on FaceTime with your friends. Now let's talk about connectivity. iPhone 15
connectivity.
Uses
what do we got?
Powerful
new Wi-Fi
and wireless technologies.
Or something?
To tell you about the exciting new wireless features coming to iPhone 15, here's Dennis.
We slide left past a beam and land at a farmer's market beside flowers and boxes of vegetables. Titles, Dennis Toma.
Are these things just like sitting around in the Apple campus? Like this is just
wireless
weird.
Wireless technologies to make everyday or activities
campus,
easier,
like
streaming
Apple
videos
Park.
With AirPlay, or easily sharing contact information with NameDrop using near-field communication. iPhone was the first smartphone with ultra-wideband, which is great for identifying where your keys are hiding in the couch. Ultra wideband is getting even better this year because just like Apple Watch, iPhone 15 has our cutting edge second generation ultra wideband chip. So iPhone 15 can connect to other devices with this chip from up to 3 times farther away. This chip also opens up a completely new way to use precision finding on iPhone 15 to find your friends. When you're in a crowded place like a train station or a farmer's market and your friends share their location, you'll be guided right to them with clear directions and distance. It's built into Find My,
so nice.
It has all the same privacy protections that users have come to trust. Of course, sometimes a phone call is the best way to reach someone. iPhone already has fantastic 5G performance, and now audio quality on phone calls is getting better too, because iPhone 15 uses a more advanced machine learning model that automatically prioritizes your voice. If you prefer to filter out even more distracting background noise, just select voice isolation and you'll come through loud.
That's already a thing.
On iPhone 15.
I'm at the farmer's market. Do you want... Hang on, it's noisy here.
She taps the screen.
Better? Great. Of course they have apples here.
It's a feature.
Okay, so
you
that's
can use
that's totally faked because right. The ambience is stereo and she's not and everything, so that was totally faked. That's not what that actually sounds like.
Zoom into the image and land on the road. Dennis walks on.
Sometimes a call can't go through because you're off the grid. When you need help in an emergency, iPhone introduced a breakthrough new service, Emergency SOS via satellite. It's having an extraordinary impact, including helping first responders rescue people after accidents and natural disasters. And users have let their loved ones know that they're safe by updating their location with Find My via satellite in places from the Shetland Islands in Scotland to Mount Wellington in Tasmania. Emergency SOS and Find My via satellite have expanded to 14 countries on 3 continents, and they're coming to Spain and Switzerland this month. Emergency SOS was built for serious emergencies that require a first responder. But say you have car trouble and no cellular or Wi-Fi service. For those times, we're introducing roadside assistance via satellite. It's built on the same advanced technology as our existing satellite.
Living
service,
by a satellite.
And it's so easy to use.
Come on, guys.
Just text roadside
assistance. We're going to introduce everything by
select what kind of help you need.
Satellite now,
then,
aren't they?
The intuitive interface will guide you to connect to a satellite and share that information with a roadside assistance provider. They'll message you directly and dispatch help to your exact location with the right equipment to get you moving. It's launching in the U.S. with AAA, the country's largest roadside assistance provider. Roadside service is covered by AAA membership and is also available separately for non-members. This is yet another way that iPhone is essential in our lives. Now, back to Cayenne.
We pull away and emerge back in the Pier warehouse.
We're thrilled to include access to these satellite services free for 2 years with iPhone 15. These best-in-class wireless capabilities keep you connected when you're on the go. Now, let's talk about iPhone's wired capabilities. The connector is used for charging, syncing data,
or are we going to be USB-C, please?
Accessories. USB-C has become a universally accepted standard. So we're bringing USB-C to iPhone 15. It enables charging, transferring data, playing audio and video, and it's been built into Apple products for years.
Yay.
Now, the same cable can charge Mac, iPad, iPhone, and even AirPods Pro second generation, which is updated with a USB-C connector. If your AirPods are low on power, you can charge them or even an Apple Watch right from your iPhone. We're also bringing USB-C to EarPods so they can work with iPhone 15 seamlessly.
Well, yeah.
And for an easy wireless connection to chargers and other accessories, iPhone 15 has MagSafe, which uses magnets with 100% recycled rare earth elements.
Of course, they're going to advertise this because they don't want you to use USB-C. They want you to use the air connector so that they get more money. Chargers,
as well as other accessories like our beautiful cases and wallets. Millions of people use these MagSafe accessories. And just like our watch bands, this gives us another opportunity for positive environmental impact by eliminating leather and introducing stunning new fine woven accessories that significantly reduce carbon emissions compared to leather. These soft and durable fine woven cases also join our silicone and clear case, all designed to perfectly complement iPhone 15. So that's iPhone 15. It has so many innovations that you can use every day, like the Dynamic Island, a 48 megapixel main camera that provides a 2x telephoto and A16 Bionic. And it has capabilities that no other smartphone has, like the ability to get emergency and roadside assistance when you're off the grid, all built into a durable color-infused design. And with all of these fantastic features, iPhone 15 is ready wherever the day takes you.
A video plays. A hand lifts an iPhone 15. It unlocks. Titles Dynamic Island. An AirPods Pro connection appears in that Dynamic Island. Now on a sidewalk, a raindrop splashes the screen. Titles Water Resistant. Now the user frames a glass building and camera with iPhone 15. They zoom in and take a photo. Titles 2x Telephoto. 48 megapixel main camera. In a coffee shop, the user touches and holds the Dynamic Island. It expands and displays a flight itinerary and countdown for takeoff. Now at home, the user frantically packs a bag. A text reads, I hope you catch your flight. Now the device rides on a conveyor belt through an X-ray machine. Titles All-day battery life. Now on the flight, the user listens to music in the sky. Titles, iPhone 15, the Apple logo.
iPhone 15 and iPhone 15 Plus are a huge leap forward. They're full of new industry-leading capabilities.
No, they're really not that huge of a leap forward.
They still start at just $799 for iPhone 15 and $899 for iPhone 15 Plus with carrier activation. We also
for the first time in a long time, Apple's
Apple
not releasing
partners,
a phone that costs $1,000.
$800 off in the U.S. when you trade in an iPhone 11 or newer. And at Apple, you'll find the latest carrier offers so you can buy and activate your new iPhone on the network you want in our stores and online. And now, back to Tim.
We tilt toward the epoxy floor of the warehouse. The epoxy fades into symmetrical squares of concrete outside Apple Park.
iPhone 15 and iPhone 15 Plus are truly incredible, with new capabilities that will make a real difference in our users' lives. Their unique combination of powerful technology, ease of use, and thoughtful design make them indispensable. And we're not done yet. Our Pro models represent the very best of Apple innovation.
Oh, there is a Pro.
Advancing features.
Okay, so maybe they will have an $1,000 one.
Performance and more. The next generation Pro pushes each of these further in ways only Apple can. And I'd like to introduce it to you now.
A video plays. A cracked and polished shard of metal hurtles through a black space. It spins forward, joining thousands of other pieces in a furious cyclone. The metallic fragments swirl and ricochet, then merge together. The fragments calm and form bold and glimmering titles. Titanium. The text ruptures into dust, revealing a sleek titanium iPhone. Light traces the contoured edges of the iPhone, then three buttons on its left side. Titanium particles swirl behind the dynamic island.
Three buttons.
The iPhone lies flat. Light dances across its camera lenses and brushed textured enclosure. Fade to black.
For a closer look at iPhone 15 Pro, the most pro iPhone we've ever created, here's Jaws.
We rise into the sky above
oh,
Apple Park.
Oh, it's Jaws.
Day turns to night and the
this
rings
guy.
Of Apple Park illuminate.
This guy's always in their events
inside,
somewhere.
Drop to the outdoor terrazzo of Steve Jobs Theater, then fly into the upper lobby. Titles, Greg Jaws Joswiak, SVP, Worldwide Marketing.
iPhone 15 Pro is packed with industry-first innovations and features our users are going to love. Powered by our most advanced Apple Silicon yet, it delivers the most incredible photos and videos. And we are thrilled to introduce our astonishing new titanium design. This is the most premium material we've ever used in an iPhone enclosure. Titanium is incredibly strong and
that's
durable.
That's nice, so it's not glass anymore.
Yet at the same time,
how is it
much
do the
lighter,
charging,
making
though?
These our lightest Pro models ever. You'll feel it as soon as you pick it up. Titanium is just beautiful. It feels fantastic with the new contoured edges, and we're also introducing the thinnest borders ever on an iPhone. This enabled us to reduce iPhone dimensions without affecting the display size. So together with the lighter weight and new edges, iPhone 15 Pro is a delight to hold in your hand. In addition to the strength of titanium, iPhone 15 Pro has the toughest glass-based materials in the industry, including the ceramic shield front, which is only available on iPhone. And there are two great display sizes to choose from, 6.1 inches for iPhone 15 Pro and 6.7 inches for iPhone 15 Pro Max. Now to tell you more about this incredible
great,
titanium
we get
four
design, frickin' iPhones.
Here's Isabel.
Titles, Isabel Yang, Materials Science Engineer.
Every material we choose for iPhone is meticulously considered. For iPhone 15 Pro, we reevaluated every structural component, inside and out, optimizing our alloy selection and creating a breakthrough innovation in manufacturing and materials design. The new enclosure uses grade 5 titanium, an alloy that has even higher tensile strength than pure titanium. It's typically reserved for applications where the balance of strength, formability, as well as weight are especially critical. In fact, this is the same alloy used on the Mars rover. Titanium has one of the highest strength-to-weight ratios
dang.
Of any metal, providing incredible durability for iPhone while enabling a much lighter design in comparison to stainless steel. The titanium encases a new aluminum substructure that is bonded using solid-state diffusion. This is an industry-first innovation, using a new thermomechanical process that joins these two metals with incredible high strength. Using aluminum on the inside creates synergistic properties with the titanium enclosure, helping with thermal dissipation and further weight reduction.
Synergistic properties.
Titanium also introduces
use those
a
words
new refined
in marketing
brush texture,
material. No one is going to know what that means.
Enabled by a unique multi-step process that includes precision machining, sanding, brushing, and blasting. And while anodizing is commonly used on titanium, we chose to use a PVD coating as added protection while introducing color. These Apple design coatings are engineered with nanometer precision and take up to 14 hours to complete, resulting in four gorgeous finishes. Black titanium and white titanium beautifully harmonize with the back glass. Blue titanium highlights the material's elegance and natural titanium celebrates its raw
wait,
metallic
back glass.
Nature.
I'm very confused. So the
there's
back is glass?
There's also a new internal chassis architecture that makes iPhone more repairable, thanks to a new structural frame that allows the back glass to be easily replaced. The entire aluminum substructure is made with 100% recycled aluminum, a first for iPhone, contributing to the overall increase in recycled materials as we work toward our 2030 goals. Now, back to Jaws.
There's another design change for iPhone 15 Pro that we're really excited about. From the very first iPhone, we've had the Ring Silent Switch, a quick and easy way to mute iPhone sounds. We wanted to make this even better. So with iPhone 15 Pro, we are reinventing the experience with a customizable action button.
That's actually pretty nice.
It's still a simple Ring Silent Switch. To toggle between Ring and Silent, you simply press and hold the button to confirm your intent. You also feel a distinctive haptic feedback for each state. And you can choose from a set of actions and easily switch between them. For example, with a simple press, you can start voice memos to quickly record a new idea or launch camera to capture that important moment. Activate a favorite accessibility feature like live speech, or you can use shortcuts to open up an even wider set of options from simply launching your favorite app to running
shortcuts
your own custom
would
shortcuts.
Would be great. I could push a button
the
on my phone and turn my lights on
and off.
That's
even more
nice.
Convenience and versatility to the iPhone experience. And every interaction gives you visual feedback with the dynamic island on the advanced Pro display of iPhone 15 Pro. In addition to the innovative dynamic island, the Super Retina XDR display also provides the smooth performance of ProMotion, the brightness and color of extreme dynamic range, and the convenience of the always-on display. And with iOS 17, we're introducing Standby, a new full-screen experience activated by turning your iPhone on its side while it's charging. With the always-on display of iPhone 15 Pro, Standby stays on persistently to show you useful information, perfect on a nightstand, kitchen counter, or desk. You can choose a simple digital clock or customize your view with multiple widgets. iPhone 15 Pro also includes a huge advancement in performance. We are excited to introduce next-level performance and more Pro capabilities than ever with the A17 Pro. For more on how this marks the beginning of a new chapter in iPhone performance, here's Sri.
We lower through the floor of the upper lobby.
Let's see if this is actually like a lot better. Pipes.
We arrive in an underground lab and glide past standing desks and Mac computers. Titles: Sri Bonlan Santhanam, VP, Silicon Engineering Group.
The A-series chip powers every experience on iPhone. For iPhone 15 Pro, we developed a new generation of Apple Silicon that is a major step forward with changes throughout the entire chip, including a breakthrough new GPU. At the foundation of this new chip is the transistor technology, and this is the industry's first 3-nanometer chip. These 3-nanometer transistors are patterned using state-of-the-art extreme ultraviolet lithography. Elements of these transistors are just over 12 silicon atoms wide. A17 Pro features 19 billion
that's
of these
really
transistors.
Tiny. I don't know if you guys realize that's
all of them
really
to
small.
Performance, efficiency, and features of our new chip. The new CPU features microarchitectural and design improvements for both our performance cores and efficiency cores. Our performance cores are now up to 10% faster, continuing to deliver the fastest single-threaded performance in any smartphone, challenging even high-end desktop PCs. Our efficiency cores are also faster and remain unmatched in the industry, delivering 3 times the performance per watt of the competition. These are critical to iPhone, as your most typical tasks run on these cores. The neural engine is now up to twice as fast for machine learning models, allowing it to process up to 35 trillion operations per second. The neural engine uses machine learning on device without sending your personal data to the cloud, powering features like typing more accurately with autocorrect, lifting a subject from a photo background, or creating a personal voice for users at risk of speech loss. A17 Pro has dedicated engines that enable Pro features. Those include the ProRes codec and a display engine that powers ProMotion and the always-on display. We also included a dedicated AV1 decoder, enabling more efficient
an AV1 decoder, seriously, jeez,
for streaming services. iPhone 15 Pro also has the new USB-C connector, but for our Pro models, we included a new USB controller in A17 Pro that enables new workflows not possible before. This is the first iPhone with USB 3 speeds up to 10 gigabits per second.
Finally, it's about freaking time.
That's up to 20 times faster than USB 2, enabling much higher transfer speeds. The groundbreaking innovation of A17 Pro is a brand new GPU with a new Apple-designed shader architecture, our biggest redesign in the history of Apple GPUs. This is a pro-class GPU that expands what's possible on iPhone even more. We focused on three things: improving performance and efficiency, running complex applications, and adding new rendering features. The new GPU is now a 6-core design, which is up to 20% faster for peak performance. And we also focused on energy efficiency that helps with sustained performance for games. We've added brand new features to the GPU, like mesh shading, which lets games create detailed environments while drawing less power. And for the first time, we have hardware-accelerated ray tracing, featuring the fastest ray tracing performance in any smartphone. Here's a scene without ray tracing that instead uses cube maps to approximate the reflections on surfaces. The light reflecting in the scene is less accurate and thus less realistic. Now here's a scene with ray-traced reflections, more accurately representing the behavior of light and reflections of the environment. With hardware-accelerated ray tracing, A17 Pro can run these graphics smoothly at much higher frame rates than with software-based ray tracing. It's a more immersive experience for games and AR applications. A17 Pro is more energy efficient and can run up to 4 times faster when compared with software-based ray tracing on A16 Bionic. Gaming is further improved with new software features, including MetalFX upscaling, which combines the performance of the GPU and Neural Engine to enable high-quality graphics while using much less power. With the fastest chip ever on any smartphone, we are excited for iPhone 15 Pro to change mobile gaming. Back to Jaws to tell you more.
iPhone is Yay. The best mobile gaming platform in the world.
Now we get to talk about gaming for like a bunch of time because I don't really care about gaming.
Yay. Advanced HDR displays, supports variable refresh rates, and is compatible with the most advanced game controllers. The App Store and Apple Arcade have revolutionized game distribution, and iPhone and iOS have a fantastic game developer community. A17 Pro takes this incredible platform even further, laying the foundation for a new generation of mobile gaming. Some of the world's best game developers are taking advantage of this new level of performance. Here's a taste of what's possible on iPhone 15 Pro.
A video plays.
Welcome to New York City in The Division Resurgence.
Titles Fabrice Navarez, Ubisoft, The Division Resurgence. In gameplay, characters run, leap, and aim down sights.
The A17 Pro allows us to push the quality of the game with improved resolution, more dynamic lightings, and even more fire and weather effects, making the game more real.
Titles Fish Long, Hoyaverse, Honkai Star Rail.
Thanks to the chip updates, we have been able to develop high-quality water features that means more realistic waves and reflections.
The character March 7th smiles and points.
On the new iPhone 15 Pro, Honkai Star Rail has never looked better.
Titles Meng Wang, Hoyaverse, Genshin Impact. Subtitles, the A17 Pro's GPU is even faster, and the MetalFX upscaling has allowed us to bring faster response times and more detailed environments to life. A character wields a sword. Subtitles, oh, I should go. Titles, Tsuyu Yoshikanda, Capcom.
But that's not all. Games like Resident Evil Village and Resident Evil 4, once only available on consoles, can now be played on iPhone, thanks to A17 Pro.
A montage of gameplay from Resident Evil Village and Resident Evil 4 plays.
This is the future of mobile gaming, all thanks to the power of iPhone 15 Pro.
A montage of gameplay from Resident Evil 4, Honkai Star Rail, Genshin Impact, and The Division Resurgence plays. Titles, welcome to the next level of mobile gaming.
A17 Pro, iPhone 15 Pro.
Wow, it's amazing to think those games are running on a device that fits in your pocket. We're excited that the Division Resurgence is launching an iPhone in early 2024. And this new level of performance will enable new games for iPhone 15 Pro that were previously only available on game consoles, PCs, or the Mac. Like Capcom's Resident Evil Village and the remake of Resident Evil 4, both launching later this year. And Ubisoft will bring Mirage, the latest installment of the Assassin's Creed franchise, to iPhone 15 Pro in early 2024. This is the first time the console version of Assassin's Creed will be natively available on a smartphone. Now let's talk about the camera. The Pro camera system is a big reason why users choose our Pro models. Built on a powerful foundation of hardware and software, it captures the most amazing photos and videos with the incredible versatility of multiple lenses. iPhone 15 Pro has our best camera system yet. Users will get even better photos and videos, powerful new features, and the equivalent of 7 camera lenses in their pocket. To tell you how we achieved this, here's Misha.
We pan away from
what they meant there was actually 7 camera lenses for a sec. I was like, what? It's the whole back of the phone, a freaking camera lens?
A wall parts revealing a design studio. Titles, Misha Skepanovic, Director, Optical Engineering.
Last year, we introduced our innovative 48-megapixel camera, which users love for their beautiful high-resolution photos. iPhone 15 Pro features a more advanced 48-megapixel main camera with an even larger sensor than iPhone 15. The camera includes a new nanoscale coating to reduce lens flare, brings high resolution to everyday photos, enables more focal lengths, and has better low-light performance for portraits and night mode. When using all pixels of the quad pixel sensor, the main camera can capture unbelievable detail, like every little scale on this lizard. In addition to 48 megapixel Pro RAW, users can now shoot in 48 megapixel HEIF with 4 times more resolution than before. And with the power of our computational photography, we have the new super high resolution default for the main camera. 24 megapixel photos merge the best of low light and detail together, as you can see here in the beautiful color of her eyes, the sharpness on the edges of her clothes, and the artistic reflection on the table. Since the new Photonic Engine now uses a 48 megapixel image, iPhone can shoot higher resolution photos in 24, 28, and 35 millimeter focal length, a very important range for pro photographers. They can now quickly switch between these new options and even choose a new default lens, customizing their camera experience to their creative needs. iPhone 15 Pro also gets next-generation portraits with focus and depth control, with 2 times better low-light performance, as you can see here in this beautiful shot. The smallest details of her expression are incredibly clear and contrasted with the dimly lit yet detailed background. You can really feel her emotion. In this photo, night mode is unbelievable. Now powered by the Photonic Engine, we can capture more color and details than ever, from the warmth of her lipstick to the creases of her white dress. Enabled by the LiDAR scanner, night mode portraits also look stunning on iPhone 15 Pro. In this shot, we captured the intricate fabric of his sweater together with a beautiful bokeh of the lights in the background. And our latest smart HDR delivers even more true-to-life photos with greater dynamic range, as you can see here with the beautiful lighting on her face and the sun reflecting on her hair, all while preserving the blue of the sky. Now, let's talk about our zoom range. iPhone 15 Pro features a great 3x telephoto camera at 77 millimeter focal length, ideal for classic portraiture. For iPhone 15 Pro Max, we're using the extra size of the larger iPhone to introduce something unique, our longest optical zoom yet. 5x optical zoom at 120 millimeter focal length. We designed a state-of-the-art telephoto camera. Compared to iPhone 14 Pro Max, it has a 25% larger sensor, 100% focus pixels, and an f2.8 aperture, the largest of any smartphone at this optical range. 120 millimeter is a very useful focal length. Great for close-ups, wildlife photos, and getting closer to the sports action. 120 millimeter lenses are typically long. So instead, we created an innovative tetraprism design built right into iPhone. The light rays are reflected 4 times through the glass structure, allowing the light to travel for longer in a much smaller design. This creates enough separation between the lens and the sensor to enable the longer focal length. And we have our most advanced stabilization yet, a combined OIS and autofocus 3D sensor shift module that moves in all 3 directions, a first for any smartphone. This was critical to support the tetraprism design. It provides even better stabilization with up to 10,000 micro-adjustments per second. That's twice as many as iPhone 14 Pro. This longer focal length gives Pro users a brand new creative option, and we can't wait to see the incredible photos they will take. The ultra-wide camera is also improved with a new anti-reflective coating, better night mode, and the latest smart HDR, in addition to enabling one of our users' favorite features on the Pro models, macro photography. Macro is one of the 7 lenses of the new Pro camera system with a 10x optical zoom range going from 13 to 120 millimeter focal length, making iPhone 15 Pro Max more powerful and more versatile than ever. Now back to Jaws.
Back in the upper lobby of Steve Jobs Theater.
Can we stop talking about cameras now?
Workflows for photographers and filmmakers that previously weren't possible.
No.
Using
apparently
a USB 3 cable with iPhone 15 Pro enables incredibly fast transfer speeds. So it's much faster to transfer your large ProRAW photos or ProRes videos to your Mac. And now you can use your iPhone with Capture One to shoot and instantly transfer 48 megapixel ProRAW directly to a Mac, easily creating a Pro Studio suited for today's fast-paced needs. iPhone 15 Pro also supports recording ProRes video directly to an external storage drive.
Video that is useful.
Can quickly swap drives and keep iPhone as the main camera on set. Recording to an external drive enables even higher quality recording options, pushing ProRes 4K up to 60 frames per second for the first time. A great option for filmmakers to create cinematic slow motion. We are also introducing log encoding to make ProRes even more powerful for our Pro users, enabling more range and flexibility for visual effects and color grading in post-production. With log encoding, iPhone 15 Pro will be the first smartphone in the world to support the Academy Color Encoding System, or ACES, a global standard for color workflows, making it easier for filmmakers to use iPhone in their production. The iPhone 15 Pro camera system pushes the limits of what you can capture with a smartphone. The precious memories you capture on iPhone look incredible when viewing with Apple Vision Pro. Photos and videos look lifelike, and panoramas expand to create an immersive experience that wraps around you. And there's one more unique feature we've created just for the world of spatial computing. With iPhone 15 Pro, you can now capture spatial videos. We use the ultra-wide and main cameras together to create a 3-dimensional video. You can then relive these memories in
like a
pair
of eyes
way on Apple Vision Pro. This is really important as your iPhone is with you all the time, so you won't ever miss capturing a special moment using spatial video, like your family's beach vacation. Spatial video lets you feel like you're right back to that moment in time.
On a couch, an Apple Vision Pro user watches the spatial video.
You can also share these spatial videos with anyone with an Apple Vision Pro so they could feel like they were there too. Capturing spatial video will be available later this year. So this is the iPhone 15 Pro, our best and most pro iPhone ever. With a new, beautiful, strong, and lighter titanium design, as well as next-level performance from the A17 Pro, a convenient and customizable action button, and our most pro camera system.
The coolest thing is the action button.
For our best photos and videos ever, including next-generation portraits and our longest optical zoom on iPhone 15 Pro Max, all while still providing great all-day battery life. The iPhone 15 Pro will start at the same price as last year, $999. An iPhone 15
yep,
Pro Max,
they are releasing
featuring
the new $1,000
5X telephoto camera, will start at $1,199 with 256 gigabytes of storage, which also matches last year's price with this level of storage. We also have incredible offers from Apple and our carrier partners, including up to $1,000 off in the U.S. when you trade in an iPhone 11 Pro or newer. All new iPhone models will be available for pre-order this Friday, September 15th, and they'll be available in stores next week on September 22nd. And starting next week, iCloud Plus is adding two new plans, 6 and 12 terabytes, for even more room to keep your photos and videos safe.
Because they're doing the high-res thing,
Plus
so
also has great features that allow you to
releasing
share
like
your photos,
more space stuff
back up your iPhone,
is probably why
so
they're doing
more.
That, because of the high-res stuff.
And of course,
stuff.
With family sharing, everyone in your household can get all the benefits of iCloud Plus. This is by far our best iPhone lineup ever. With Dynamic Island across the iPhone 15 lineup, incredible new camera systems, and powerful features that you'll use throughout the day. And the iPhone lineup starts at just $429 with iPhone SE. Now, back to Tim.
We drift out of the glass walls of the upper
lobby.
All
right, so I'm assuming this is mostly it, but we'll find out here.
The trees and long grasses along the outdoor terrazzo brighten, and the sky turns orange, pink, and light blue. Tim approaches.
Thank you, Jaws. Thanks to all of our presenters, and thanks to everyone
who worked on these
amazing products that are so indispensable in our daily lives. Apple Watch Series 9, with our most powerful chip ever in Apple Watch, a brighter display, and a convenient new way to interact with your watch. And it's our first carbon-neutral product. Apple Watch Ultra 2, our most rugged and even more capable watch, now featuring Apple's brightest display ever. iPhone 15 and iPhone 15 Plus, now with Dynamic Island, an incredible camera system featuring a 48-megapixel main camera and the power of A16 Bionic in a gorgeous new design. An iPhone 15 Pro in titanium for a durable, light, and stunning finish. With the new A17 Pro, the fastest chip ever in a smartphone, a customizable action button, and our most pro camera system yet, featuring a 5X telephoto camera. These are the best and most capable iPhones we've ever made. At Apple, we strive to create innovative products and best-in-class experiences that help us do the things that matter most in our lives. Apple Watch and iPhone are essential. They're with us all the time, and we use them throughout the day, which is why we're so excited for you to begin using these incredible new devices. Thank you for joining us. Have a great day.
Fade to black. Blue and white.
I'm sure you are excited to get more money.
Then stills forming a vibrant Apple logo. The
Apple
logo. Title.
We don't need to listen to all of that. Initial impressions. We aren't getting anything super duper exciting this year. That's starting to be expected from Apple because there's not a lot of places they can really innovate anymore. We still got some handy new features. The action button on the phone was cool. I think, like, that's the most exciting thing to me. That just goes to show how unexciting this event was. There's probably a lot of details that were left out of the event. This felt very undetailed compared to how they usually are. I don't know what that was about. It's very exciting that they're pushing for more natural environment for them building their products and just a more natural building process in general, and also making it so that their products contain much more recyclable material. It's very, very exciting to me. This is very important. People don't seem to realize how important this is. I'm glad that Apple is making those steps, and I'm hoping that a lot of other companies will follow in their footsteps. Those are my initial impressions. Thanks for listening. Bye-bye.